So good evening, everybody. So I welcome everybody for this lab session on Advanced Java Programming Laboratory. So today we will discuss about the 8th program in this session. See, what is this 8th program says that write a JSP program to get student information through HTML and create a Java Bean class, okay, populate Bean and display the same information through another JSP, right? This is about the program number 8, okay? So all of you look at this particular diagram here. See, here in this particular diagram, what you have, you're seeing that web browser, web server. Inside the web server, you have a JSP and Java Bean, right? You have a, right. Now what happens, what the program says here, you have to create one index.html page, right, which contains the student information. The student information includes name, USN and branch. That information you have to create in index.html, right? Now in Java Bean, what you have to do, see, Java Bean is nothing but it is a class, Java class, right? Now you are going to create one class with the name student. So you are going to create three instance variable, that is name, USN and branch, right? So for each instance variable, you are going to create setter and getter method for name, okay, for USN, right, for branch, right? Setter method is used to set the value. Getter method is used to retrieve the value. Now what happens, that index.html information, you are going to send it to the JSP page here. Now through JSP program, using the action tags, the JSP provide three action tags for this. One is called useBean. Second one, set property. Third one is the get property. So using the set, first you're going to initialize the bean. After initializing the bean, this Java Bean, you are going to set the properties, right? By calling the setter property, right? And you are going to, after setting the value, again, using the same JSP program, you are going to retrieve the values, right, using get property. Then you are going to display that information using another JSP page, right? So this is about the program. So I am going to demonstrate this particular program by using the NetBeans editor, right? Now I am going to create one project, right? Click on file, new project, right? Then Java web, web application, lab, program 7. Okay, then I'll click next. Then I'll select the Java W5, click next. Okay, then click on finish. Okay. Now here you see the Java web application, sorry, the web application will be created here with the name lab program 7. Here we have default index.jsp. Okay. In this particular page, right? See, they told you to create using the index.html. So I'll delete this. Right, so here I'll right click on this web page, then I'll create one HTML page. I'll give the name as index, right? Then I'll click finish. Right, this is index.html. So in the configuration file, you have to change the this file name to index.html, right? This is a welcome page, right? So after that, what you have to do here, right? You have to create the student information here, right? To save the time, I'll just cut and copy the information. I'll just copy the information directly. See here, what information, I'll save this, I'll copy this information here, right? See, now this particular form tag contains the name, USN, branch of the student, right? So I'll just print some message here, H1, just like student information and system, right? Student information system, right? Now what you have to do, see, I'll create in this source package, I'll create one class, okay? The name of a class I'll give. How to create a class? See, right click on this default package, new, here Java class. You give the class name as student. Okay? And save it in one package called ABC. Okay, then click finish. See here, what happens here? Here, one Java class will be created here, right? Just you have the class name here, right? The class name is student, right? See, what you have to do, you create one three fields here. What is the three fields that you're going to create here? See, these are the three fields you created here, right? Private, that is student name, USN number, and branch, right? These three fields you create here, see here, right? After that, you select these three fields. What is the first field name? See, these are the private fields. See, data type, S name, USN number, branch is of type string, and it is declared as private. Now what you have to do, you have to copy this and you have to create appropriate setter and getter methods. See, these are the private variables, right? How to access the private variables of a class? By using the public member functions, right? Now here, I'll generate the code automatically. You just, you select this and right click this, and you have some option called insert code. You click on this insert code. Here you have setter and getter. You just copy this. See, this window will open here. The name of the window is generate setter and getter. You copy this class. The fields will be copied automatically. Then you click on this encapsulate fields, then generate. See what happens here, the setter and getter methods for these three fields will create automatically, right? Now you just see here, for example, you take this S name, this is field, right? For this field, the set name method will be created automatically. What is it will do? It will set the name, right? So it will receive the, see, this particular set name will have the argument, will receive the argument of type string, and you're going to set this name using this dot name, right? What is this? This pointer, this pointer is a pointer which points to the currently invoked object, right? Now what happens, you use this get USN number. Now after setting this USN, you have to use this get USN to retrieve that value. And one more thing is that you have to implement this student, right? See, you have to, the student class, you have to implement the serializable interface. So this is a serializable interface, right? So you just import this method, import java.io.serializable, right? You have to implement this interface, right? Now, what happens here? So this is a bean class. So the bean class means it should implement the serializable interface, and it should have the zero arguments constructor, right? Now see, this is a student class here, right? Student class, right? You have the appropriate setter and getter methods for each variable, for student name, USN number, and branch, right? So this is a class name which implements the serializable, right? So why you are going to implement the serializable, right? To transfer, what you say that, to save the state of the object, right? Now you just see here, this is what you call as a Java bean. Now usually how you are going to execute a Java program, right? Now this is a class. Now you are going to use one more class which contains the public static void main. Then what you are going to do, you are going to create an object of a class using that object, and you call the set name to initialize this data member, and get name to retrieve the data member, right? Data member. So we don't have this now. We don't have here. We don't have the public static void main, right? Now this is what you call as a Java bean. What is this Java bean? It is a reusable Java component. So what is the purpose of this, right? To use this, see what happens. Why we are going to use the beans, right? See, just I'll tell you this. See, now you this is a bean here. Now I have to, now main task is that I have to initialize the bean, right? I have to initialize the bean, and I have to set the properties and retrieve the properties. How I should do this? See here, first I'll set the information here. First, I'll take this index.html. I'll take the USN name, USN branch. See, one more thing is that the name field has to match with this Java beans instance variable. There should be one-to-one mapping here. See, sname should match with this property name here. This name, and USN should match with that instance variable, and branch should match with the instance variable, right? Then only you can set and retrieve the information. Now you just see here what happens here. I'll create one more JSP page, right? I'll name it as set property, right? Set property. Now I'll create the JSP page here. See here, new JSP. The name I'll give it as set property. Okay, I'll click on this, finish, right? This is a JSP page, right? Using this, I'll set the properties of a bean. See here, I'll just show you. I have one method called as a set property. See this code, I'll just copy and paste it. See, see, I'll use this. These are the action tag here, right? Right, these are the action tag which is been provided by the JSP, right? Now what is this action tag? It is nothing but the runtime instruction given to the container, right? Now you just see here, we have use bean. See, this is one action tag, right? Use bean. It is having the two attributes. One is called as an ID, second attribute called as a class, third attribute called as a scope, right? In ID, you should give the ID. So you're going to identify this tag uniquely. What is the tag? Use bean. So then you have a class. You should give the full package name. See here, whatever that ABC is a package name and student is a class. See, you have to give full complete path here for this attribute called as a class. Scope is a request scope. See, as we have discussed here, we have four type of scopes here. Lowest one is a page. Second, above that you will get a request. Then session, then application, right? So this request scope will come in the second level from the bottom, right? Now what happens? You are going to search, see, in the particular current JSP page, you are going to search this particular class, right? In the scope of the request, right? Next, if the bean is not found, you think that this bean, using this ID only, you are going to, what you say, search this particular bean, right? Now, if this particular bean is not found, right, it will create a new bean, okay? See, for instance, you take this is an ID, right? So you're going to identify this action attribute uniquely, and you have a class. This is a class name you have to give here. Then you have a scope here, request scope, okay? See here, and we have set property. What is the use of this set property? See, for setting the property. See, now here you just check it here. Set.index.html is there, no? Whatever that value that you're going to enter it here, s name. So the set property, what it will do, right? So that name, using this bean, right? Bean. Then the property name, you're going to set the property name, s name. Where it will be set? Here, s name. S name, you're going to set here. This method will be called. This method will be called by using this bean name, right? Yes or no? Now for example, name. For example, I'll enter Sachin here. The Sachin will be set here, right? So using this property called as a set property, which is being provided by whom? It is being provided by the JSP. This is an action tag. So the three properties I'll set here. Okay, I'll set in. Now, in this particular Java, the value is being initialized. First, the name value is being initialized by Sachin, and USN number 1CD MCA 08, and branch is MCA. You think that, right? Now I have set the values here. I have to access the values. How should I access the values? See, now what I'll do it here, I'll just forward the page to this get details page, right? So I'll use this view details page. I'll send the request to this particular page. See, I'll use one more action tag here, forward. What it will do, the forward, it will transfer the control to this particular page. Now what happens here? Right click, JSP. See, I'll create one more JSP page, view student detail. I'll just finish this. See, then what I'm going to do, I'll use one more property that is called as a get property. Right? I'll use this get property to retrieve the value of the bean. See, here, now I have set the value inside this bean. Now I have to retrieve the value of bean. How should I retrieve? See here, I'll use this get property here, action tag. Before that, you have to use this particular line. You have to use bean. Then the same ID, what you have used in the set property, you have to use the same ID, class, the full package name, the scope request. Right? I use the request scope. Then see, I want to retrieve the name. How should I retrieve? I'll use this action tag, JSP get property. Name, I'll use this bean. And the property is sname. The same property, see here. Yes, name. You have to use the same property name what you have used here, right? Yes, name. USN number. Then branch. See here, I have used it here. Yes, name. USN number. Branch to display the information about name, USN, and branch. Right. Now you just see here. I'll execute this program and I'll show you. I'll just deploy this. Right. So when I'm going to deploy this, now I'm going to run this. So when I'm going to run this, right, you will get this output. You'll get this output. Then you're going to enter here. Suppose that I'll enter Pankaj. USN number 1CD MCA08, branch is MCA. So when I click the submit button, what should happen? See, the information has to be displayed here.